Hello, hello, hello. Welcome back to my channel. I am Monae and you are watching Life as Monae. I recently hopped back into my fantasy bag and I have been having a good time falling in love with reading some epic fantasies again. And it has inspired me to go shopping for some new fantasy books because honestly, I spent most of this year reading books from other genres. I have not really paid attention to any new releases and it's been a long time since I have really looked and perused the shelves in the adult fantasy section. And since I'm interested, I feel like it's the perfect time to go shopping, really look at the shelves, and I'm gonna use the try a chapter method while I'm in the store to make sure that I'm purchasing books that I actually want to read, actually am interested in, and have some type of expectations for it and hope it doesn't let me down. And I feel like the trying a chapter in the store would be the perfect way to do that. So I'm gonna head to Barnes and Nobles and I will check back with you guys. A relatively quiet part of the store, so we're gonna start going through these books. I did not read the synopsis for anything, so I figure the first round of eliminations should be that. Let's do that first. So first up we have the Ember Blade. Synopsis of this one sounds so freaking good. It sounds like a revenge story. Very interested in that. And then we have The Thousand Deaths of Arthur Ben. This sounds like Theft of Swords, so very interested in this one. This is a yes. I feel like it's gonna be so hard to eliminate some of these. Then we have Fate of the Fallen. This sounds very interesting. This is a maybe. Then we have The Shadow in the Glass. Also another maybe. Now we have The Unwilling. This sounds like Guild, but in a high fantasy setting, so this is going in the yes pile. Then we have The Last Unicorn. I'm gonna say no to this one. I don't think I'm interested in this one. Then we have The Tethered Mage. This is going in our yes pile. Then we have The Red Knight. This also sounds a little similar to Theft of Swords, so this is a maybe. And then we have The Goblin Emperor. This sounds like a yes. And then we have The Black Ghost. Not today, this is a no. And then we have The Master of Sorrow. This is a maybe. And then we have Spine of the Dragon. This is going in probably the yes pile. This sounds really interesting. So these two are the ones that did not make the first cut, so this is a no. These are our piles of maybe at a later date. And then these are the ones that we're gonna try the first chapter of. Okay, we have finished the first chapter of our books and I got rid of this one because the writing is too dense from what I'm looking for right now, and it feels like it's gonna be extremely slow, and yeah, I'm just not in the mood for this. This plot sounds very intriguing, but I can already tell that he's gonna take forever to get to the point. So the first part of this book is a prologue, and it did nothing to set up the world, not really, and I just was not interested at all. The writing feels very like whimsical, but with no purpose. It feels pretentious with no purpose. So this is also a no. And so in our yes pile so far, we have The Ember Blade, The Tethered Maid, The Goblin Emperor, The Thousand Deaths of Artaban. These were, the first chapters were really, really good, like super engaging. I'll do a more in detailed thought on the first chapter later, because I'm not even sure if you guys can hear me right now, but yeah, these are gonna go home with us because the first chapter was really, really good. I'm like excited for these. So since I removed two books, I almost want to go back and like do one more look through. Yeah, I think we're gonna do that. I'm gonna look one more time to see if we can add one more, and if not, it's probably gonna be these. So we're officially back home. I sincerely thought that reading a chapter before I left the store would help me eliminate them more, but I really only eliminated two, and the other chapters were just so good. It made me want to purchase it more, especially based off the first chapter. So I will do an update after I read these to let you know if the first chapter consistently held up my expectations from reading it as I continued throughout the book. But yeah, the first chapters of all of these were really good, and we're gonna discuss them in detail because I have my bag here. So the first book is going to be The Thousand Deaths of Artaban. I know that I didn't get a chance to really read the synopsis to you guys in the store. So this says Artaban is no ordinary thief. Rakish, ambitious, and a master of wildly complex heists, he styles himself a ruse artistic extraordinaire. When he gets hired for his most daring ruse yet, Artaban knows he'll need more than quick wit and a sleight of hand. Assembling a dream team of forgers, disguisers, schemers, and thieves, he sets out to steal from the most powerful king the realm has ever known. But it soon becomes clear that there's much more at stake than fame and glory. Ard and his team might just be the last hope for human civilization. I don't know, like in the first chapter, I really enjoyed the writing. It was super calming, and it honestly reminded me of Michael J. Sullivan's writing in Theft of Swords. And that's a series that I am loving more and more with every book that I read. And Artaban was super like snarky and sarcastic in the first chapter, and just really engaging and intriguing. And like I said, the writing was very digestible. So for the first chapter, this one made me want to read it more. When I was there, I seen that there's three books in this series, in this world, I guess, and they're all pretty chunky like this. So I'm hoping to really like this, and I'm not putting like a lot of pressure on this series, but if this book or this series lives up to even like half of the enjoyment that I had while reading Theft of Swords, then I would just be satisfied. Like if this is even a 3-star, then I'm gonna read book 2. Second book that I purchased is going to be The Tethered Mage. In the Ravaran Empire, magic is scarce, and those born with power are strictly control taken as children and conscripted into the Falcon Army. Zyra has grown up on the streets to avoid this fate, hiding her mage mark and thieving to survive. But hers is a rare and dangerous magic, one that threatens the entire empire. Lady Amalia Cornaro was never meant to be a falconer. Heiress and scholar, she was born into a treacherous world of political machinations. But fate has bound the Air, and the Mage. War looms on the horizon. A single spark could turn their city into a pyre. The first chapter of this one was really like captivating. The writing was very digestible again, and there's a lot of intrigue from the first chapter that makes you want to like, I feel like this is going to be a compulsive read because I did not want to stop after the first chapter. I read a couple of pages past the first chapter because it just feels like such a compelling read. The next two I expect to be like 4 and 5 stars just from the first chapter. It was so freaking interesting. We have The Goblin Emperor. Born of a marriage made only as part of a treaty, the youngest son of the emperor has lived his entire life in exile, far from his father and the imperial court. He knows little of the rituals of the empire. He knows less about the deadly intrigue that surrounds the government and the court. But when his father and his 3 half-brothers die suddenly, Maya is summoned to take his rightful place on the throne. For Maya, life in the capital is a bewildering daily test. He is surrounded by strangers. He has no way to know who he can trust, and before long, he discovers his father and half-brother's death were no accident. The ship was tampered with. The crash was murder. So the writing in this one was a little more pretentious than the first two books, The Tethered Mage and Art of Ben. However, like in the first chapter, we follow Maya as he finds out that his father was just murdered. His feelings really came to life and like how shocked he was, and it took him a minute to like really understand the gravity of the situation in terms of like what had just happened to him. I feel like where this book started was perfect in the story, and I'm very interested to keep going because there was already so much intrigue, and like you got to understand a little bit of the hierarchy in this world that they lived in, and Maya seems like a character that I'm really going to enjoy reading from. So very interested in him. I feel like this one is going to be one of my more favorites from this haul. So I'll be sure to update you guys to let you know if this lived up to my expectations. And then this one was a definite yes from when I read the synopsis on the back of the book. I already knew that I was going to purchase it, and then just reading the first chapter really solidified that for me, and that is going to be The Ember Blade. The synopsis of this one says, Arin has lived by the rules all his life. He's never questioned it. That's just the way things are. But then his father is executed for treason, and he and his best friend Cade are thrown into a prison mine, doomed to work until they drop, unless they somehow break free. But what lies beyond the prison walls is even worse. Rescued by a man who hates him, yet is oath-bound to protect him, pursued by inhumane forces, Arin slowly accepts that the rules are not there to protect him or his people, but to enslave them. A revolution is brewing, and Arin is being drawn into it, whether he likes it or not. The Ember Blade is the key, the sword of kings, the Excalibur of his people, but it's locked in an impenetrable vault in the most heavily guarded fortress in the land. All they have to do is steal it. This sounds like a very high epic fantasy story. In the first chapter of this one, we actually don't follow Arin. We follow 2 different characters that are kind of trying to escape these people who may possibly be following them. And there was this sense of like desperation coming across the page, and there was this relationship dynamic between our 2 characters that made me more interested. And also, I want to see how these characters are going to tie in to Arin when we do get to him. I feel like this one is going to be another one that I really enjoy reading. If I'm making predictions based off the first chapter, I feel like this one would be my top favorite. This one would be my second. Then I feel like 3rd place would be a toss-up between The Tethered Mage and The Thousand Deaths of Art of Ben. Both feel like they could come in the 3rd slot. The last book that I added ended up being a replacement for the 2 that we eliminated in the store, and that is going to be A Master of Sorrows. The synopsis of this one says, you've heard the story before. An orphaned boy raised by a wise old man comes to a fuller knowledge of his magic and uses it to fight the great evil threatening the world. But what if that hero were destined to become the new Dark Lord? There is this secret academy in this world that appears to be centuries old, and they train their students on how to find and steal magical artifacts so that other people don't misuse them. Of the academy's many students, only the most skilled can become avatars. Warrior thieves capable of infiltrating the most heavily guarded vaults, and only the most determined can be trusted to resist the lure of magic. But Anub is supposed to be different from the other students at this academy because he was born in a different village, and people assumed that he had been executed at birth, but he wasn't. And he ended up being raised by the people who murdered his parents. It says 17 years later, he struggles with the burdens of a forbidden magic, a
forgotten heritage and a secret deformity. When he is caught between the warring ideologies of his priestly mentor and the Academy's masters, he must finally decide whether to accept the truth of who he really is or embrace the darker truth of what he may one day become. It seems like a coming of age story to a villain, or like a villain origin story, and I've been told that this seems like a book that I would really enjoy. I was interested in this book a while ago. I want to say last year or maybe a year and a half ago, I read like 3 pages and I was reading about a baby being born. And now I know that that was actually just a prologue, but I remember like reading about the birth, and I don't know what happened, but it was just like, no, this book is not for me, because I just assumed, I don't know what I thought. I was actually reading a sample that was delivered to my iPad from Kindle, and I actually don't really like ebooks, and that could play a huge part into like why I decided I wasn't interested in reading this book, because I remember returning the sample and like I never thought of it again. But since I was in the store, I actually got a chance to read the entire prologue, and I was just like, okay, we're gonna give this book a chance, because I was interested in it before and I didn't give it a fair shot the first time, so we're gonna try this time and see it all the way through. These are the books that we grabbed today at Barnes & Noble's. I feel like today was very successful. I'm actually very excited for all of them. Now that I've had a chance to read the synopsis and read the first chapter of the prologue for all of them, I know, like, I feel more confident in my purchase now. So I think I'm going to use the try a chapter more often as I'm shopping, because it makes me more confident in my purchases. And it compels me to want to read them faster, because I've already kind of jumped a little bit into the story and I'm invested in all of them. And so yeah, if you've made it to the end of this video, comment below right now which of these you think will end up being my favorite. Also comment below if you want me to do a vlog of me reading any of these books and which books you would want to see my in-depth thoughts about, because I know that some of you guys may be wanting to read these too. Thanks for shopping with me, and I will see you guys next time.